It's a good day when a B&H package arrives.
I just wanted to chat with you guys for a real quick second here. I ordered, so new package came from B&H. As you know, if you're a filmmaker, I'm a DP and director. Buying gear is addictive, and you need it to improve. I mean, once you get to a certain spot, you probably won't buy gear anymore, but I don't really see myself ever fully stopping buying gear because it is fun to get new stuff, okay? When filmmaking's your hobby and your job, it's cool because you can buy stuff you like and it actually helps you, and you can tell yourself, you know what? I'm not just buying this. Okay. Luke, what did you get? This is crazy. Tell us what you got. Give me 1 second. I need to show you what I bought. So before I reveal what's in the bag, I want to show you this. It's a, you can see my setup here on my phone. Small rig, 99 watt V-mount battery. Now, I do not own a camera with a V-mount system. I'm currently using a Canon R6 Mark II, and you're asking yourself, wait a minute, why did Luke buy a V-mount battery? That's a great question. That's what I'm here to answer. Today I'm talking about deals in the camera industry or film industry. And I also am wondering for you as the viewer, this is also like, hey, what would you do in this situation? If you're a filmmaker, when you see a deal for gear, so right now I'm looking at buying the FX6, which is a Sony cinema camera, and that's going to be the next camera. And by the time this vlog comes out, I actually might have bought it by now. I'm actually backlogged about 6 vlogs ahead. And I think I'm going to buy it in a week from now, which is, it's been a journey. It's been a 5-month journey of saving money, which is epic, but also it took a while. But I bought this V-mount for $150 off. And what's in the bag? Big reveal. I bought a Tough 960 gigabyte card, a C-Express Type A card for my FX6, future FX6. And then I bought these lav concealers. I'll link all of this stuff actually in the description. David Moorfield, one of my favorite YouTubers, filmmakers, cinematographer, was using these with his Sony UDP mics, which I've been using the Moleskine, it's called tape sandwich, where you put basically like 2 pieces of tape to conceal the mic, but this is a hard version and it will conceal the mics even better. So I picked these up just as well as a little fun thing to pick up. But yeah, I picked these two things up before I owned the camera. Weird, right? I mean, knowing, if you know you're going to buy the camera, it's like in the long term, I was gonna have to get both of these things anyways, because I'm rigging out my FX6, and storage wise, the SD cards don't work as well, and or you can't use like all of the feature. There's a lot of reasons why you would use a C-Express card. It's just better overall for a cinema camera, and it's better to have a branded. Now, another question, which I probably should have done this research before, and I did research, is why is it an M here and on others it's like an A? So if you have the answers to that, and also, do you buy gear for the future? Do you buy, like, would you, if you were in my place, would you have bought these things if they're on sale? Because stuff on B&H only comes in, and that's where, come on, B&H is the best. You can buy on Amazon too, but B&H just has a better experience overall. Overall, feels a little bit safer buying camera gear. Not that Amazon isn't, but like B&H is, that is their thing. So I feel better going with B&H. But I bought both of these things, and this was expensive. Like this was like $900 originally, and I got it for $750, which is crazy. And I wonder if the deal is actually still going. I think it's usually about a week or two. They lowered the price overall on these cards because stuff over time eventually will get a little bit lower, at least camera-wise. But yeah, I purchased these. Just a little bit of a B&H haul because it's fun to show off the lav concealers. And I got this a couple weeks ago. It's the small rig battery, which it looks great. I haven't actually tried any of this stuff yet because I don't own the camera. But it is an interesting thought process to say, like, because I had these things in my cart and I was looking, okay, I'm going to get the camera first, and then I'm going to get the options to rig it out. Then I would get the battery. SD card would probably be before the battery or sorry, C Express card, not SD card. Need to get in the habit of saying that. And these I would have bought anyways. They were only like $20. But yeah, it was an interesting, I was like, do I pull the trigger here? Do I buy these things that I need eventually? I was going to get the Angel Bird 1 terabyte, but they are no longer making those and they're sold out everywhere. So why is it 960 gigabytes? There's, it feels so weird. Like, why wouldn't you just round up to a terabyte? I don't know. A lot of yapping today, short little vlog, little haul, but yeah. Let me know in the comments below whether or not you buy stuff before, like if you buy accessories before you get the actual thing, depending if it's on a deal. I wouldn't do this if I wouldn't have gotten a deal for it, if that makes sense. Thank you guys for watching. Have a great day.